Okay, let's take a look at today's bell work here. And what we're talking about is the interior angle measure. And it says find the angle measure. And I guess that's total angle measure. So it's going to be n minus 2 times 180. And that equals the interior angle measure. And so what we're going to do here is figure out how many sides. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If it has 6 sides, do you know what it's called? Hexagon is correct. So that's going to be 6 minus 2. And remember, n represents the number of sides. So it's going to be 4 triangles. Each triangle is worth 180 degrees. So you take your calculator, and you take 4 times 180, and that gives you 720. So the interior angles, if you add all these up, would be 720 degrees. Now, the question for number 2 wants to know, what is the measure of one of them? Well, if it's a regular polygon, that means all of these are the same. So you can take 720 and divide by 6, because there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 angles. So divide by 6, and you get 120 degrees. So this would be 120 degrees for angle A. And in fact, all of those angles would be 120 degrees. Next. It says the measure of each angle of a regular polygon is 156. Find the number of sides. Well, the formula, and this was at the end of yesterday's lesson, so if you were stuck, here it is. The interior angle measure is equal to n minus 2 times 180. That gives you the whole interior angle, all of them, okay? But what we don't know is the number of sides. So if you take the whole thing and you divide by n, which is the number of sides, that gives you one angle, which is 156. Okay? So in other words, on this side you have one angle, and if you divide this by n, the number of sides, this would be one angle. So now you have one angle equal to one angle. So you cross multiply or multiply by n, and you get 156n is equal to this. Now we're going to distribute, so that's going to be 180n minus 360. Okay, 2 times 180. And now what you're going to do is subtract 156 from both sides. Okay, and you're going to get 0 on this side. And this right here is 6, 70, 80, so I think that's 24n. You can check my math. And then you see how that's a negative 360? Well, you want to add 360 to get it on this side. So put plus 360. I guess I could have left that 0 there. And so now you're going to divide by 24. So 360 divided by 24 is going to give me 15. So it has 15 sides. And that's how you work it. And again, the key here is if 156 represents one angle, then if you take the sum and divide by n, which is the number of sides, you would have one angle equal to one angle. Then you multiply by n, distribute, you move the 156 over here and subtract, and then move the 360 over here and then divide. Okay, not too bad, not too hard, but that's how you do the last part of the work from yesterday. So put away your bell work, and let's talk about today's work, okay? Now, today's work, we're talking about exterior angle measure. And again, I expect everyone to check their answers. So put 10.5 on a new sheet of paper, and here we go. It says, identify the term illustrated by the arrow. Well, this is called an exterior angle. So I want you to draw this diagram. Let me make it bigger. Okay? And these are the interior. And this looks like a pentagon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but this is called an exterior angle. And if you extend this one out, this is an exterior angle. If you extend this one out, that's an exterior. Extend this one out, that's an exterior. It almost looks like one of those Chinese darts that they throw, and it spins and sticks on the wall or whatever. All right, so this is called an exterior angle. And what you need to know is that all the exterior angles, no matter what polygon it is, okay, add up to 360 degrees. Will always add up to 360 degrees. So If you want to know what one of these is, since it's a regular, it looks like a regular one, so you would divide by 5. So 360 divided by 5 would actually give you one of those, which is 72 degrees. So each of these exterior angles would be 72 degrees. On number 2, or this one right here, number 4, they want you to draw the exterior angles. So copy down number 4, and then just, it doesn't matter how you do it. So that's an exterior. Extend this one out. That's an exterior. That's an exterior. And that's an exterior. Make it look like that, okay? And all of those add up to 360. All right, let's go on. Calculate the measure of the exterior angles for each polygon. Well, the sum of the exterior angle, no matter what it is going to be 360. So it doesn't matter what it is. They all should be 360. So I want you to check these in the back of the book to make sure, okay? And I want you to check all of them, as a matter of fact. All right, let's move on. Let's try number 15. What is the measure of an exterior angle if the adjacent interior angle is 108? Well, if the interior angle of whatever it is 108, then you draw a line like this, and now you have a straight line. And you know linear pair and supplementary, a straight line adds up to 180 degrees. So if you have 108, then the inside or the exterior angle has to be 72 because it's got to add up to 180. Okay, so the exterior angle would be 72 degrees. And that's how you work that. All right, let's go on. I think that's pretty much it, actually. Let's see. Oh, okay. Let's go to this one right here. It says find the number of sides given the exterior angle. So you have an exterior angle. So you know that the exterior angles, okay, copy down number 2, or 26 rather. The exterior angle is, say, let me get a different one. Copy down number 28. The exterior angle is 60 degrees. If the exterior angle is 60 degrees, the formula is the sum of the exterior angles will add up to 360 degrees, okay? But you only have one of them. So if you put one exterior angle on this side, which is 60 degrees, then you'd have to divide this by n to get one on this side, okay? So now what you're going to do is cross multiply here, or multiply by n. So you get 60n is equal to 360, and then you divide by 60. So 360 divided by 60, clear that out. 360 divided by 60 is going to give you 6 sides. Okay? And again, let me reiterate that. The sum of all exterior angles, no matter how many sides the polygon has, is 360. If they tell you one of them, then you have to divide 360 by n to make one on this side. So you'd have one angle on this side and one angle on this side, and then you multiply by n. That's the key concept. If you have one on this side, you have to have one on that side. And the way you do it is you put the number of sides, or you take the total divided by the number of sides, which is n. Okay, I want you to do 1 through 30 all. And this is 10.5, I believe. So have a good morning.